Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This video is a continuation of my previous video in which I showed how to send emails from Google Sheet with the help of Google Apps Script. But my previous video, there was only one email address like this, right? And that code was picking this email address and subject line with the mail body and sending it to the Gmail account. Let me run this script again. And we'll go to my Gmail account once, and we can see that we will receive an email. Okay, so we got email sent, we got the subject one, and in two we have the email address. Cool. So this code is working for only one email address. Now, for example, let's take a real life scenario where you have a list of email addresses and you have different types of subject lines. Okay, and you have some email body as well. Now you want to send all the mails to all these email addresses with respective subjects and email body. Let's move to the script and try to modify. Okay, so we know that this code is working for one line. That means if I use some iteration loops, it can be done for other rows as well, because for row number two, right, it is picking the row number two values and it is sending the mails, that is for sure. So that means I'm going to apply some loop. So in this we are going to use for loop. I will just write I equals to 0, I less than something. Okay, it's not decided yet. I plus plus, this is the format, right? So basically it will iterate. This loop will, let's close the loop first. Yeah, so that means this loop will iterate. Okay, now I equals to 0, just look this at like this, that this is a counter. If you are looping something, the loop should know from where I am starting, what is my starting point, and up till when I have to do this looping, correct? So let's suppose this is a starting point, 0 is our starting point, and now I is less than something. So till when we want to loop? The point is, till when we want to send the emails, right? So we are sending the email here, correct? So that means till which counter we have to send the emails. So we'll just go to, we'll just move to this page, and let's count the total number of email address, which is 7, right? So I'll just go back. Okay, so let's suppose it is 7. Now the count of the email IDs was 7, but as we are starting from 0, it should be 6. I can say less than equals to 6. Okay, so that, so basically we are starting from 0, that's why we are taking 1, like the last number minus 1, so that 0 1 2 3 4 5 6, it will be 7 total in count. Got it. So this line is set, my loop is ready. Now how these variables come to know that from where they have to pick the data? Earlier they were picking from A2, B2 and C2, and that particular variables were passing in this particular line, right? So now we are going to tell our code that where to pick from. So we know that the first line in which the email address is row number 2, and the last line is row number 8, correct? So the starting row is the row number 2. Cool. So I'll just delete the numbers from here, because these are hard coded, right? Okay, now to concatenate, to get a iterated value, I'll just use plus sign and I'll use I here. And what is I? I is this, correct? This particular thing, this basically will make get range to A0, because in the first iteration the value will be 0, correct? So 0 will come here and it will become A0, but as we can see that in Google Sheet there is nothing like 0. So the minimum value is A1, the first cell is A1. So that means 0 cannot be there. So we have to something with 0, right? We have to add something with 0 so that we can reach A2, right? So we have to reach 2 so that the first value can be picked. That means I plus 2. Okay, the first value will be 0 plus 2 equals to 2, and A plus 2 is A2. So that means it will go to A2 cell in first iteration, right? I think there is some error. Okay, now it is too cool. So this is for sure, this will be applied to others as well, right? And bracket is very necessary when you are concatenating numbers with alphabets like this. Okay, these two brackets are very important. So for example, let's suppose first iteration will happen and it is 0, it will come to this line, it will take A 2 and dot get value. Got it? A2, B2, C2, mail will be sent. Now iteration will move to next number, and instead of 0 it will be 1. It will come here, 1 plus 2, 3. 3, 3. So ideally it should work, right? Let's run the code. It should work. Let's just see what is the output. I'm just running this code. I'll go to here. Whether I receive mails or not, let me check. Cool. We are getting mails. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We got all 6. We got 7. Cool. We got 7. How many IDs were there? Total IDs were 7. Perfect. That means our code is perfect. But there is only one slight issue in this. We have hard coded 6 in this. Correct? That means we already know how many email IDs are there. Now for example, you have these many email IDs. This code will not change, and it will only send 6 emails, 7 emails. So the next point which we have to work on is we have to get the count. Count means, for example, what is the count of the IDs. So basically, when we talk about formulas, I'll just do this. Okay, what is the count? 7. But in Google Sheets we can apply this formula, count A2:A, and we can also reference, if we want we can also reference it and take the value from here, but that will not be efficient. So either you can say it is a count, or I can say if everything is saved in some variable, all these email IDs will be saved in one variable. That variable, you can call that variable as a container. If I can get the length of that container, that will also work, because the length will be the count. Correct? So I'll come here, I'll just write variable email array. Okay, and I'll say I'm calling spreadsheet app open by URL. Okay, URL will be the same, this Google Sheet URL. Cool. Now get range, and what is our range? What was the range here in count? A2:A. Correct. I'll just type A2:A. It will take complete A till bottom means till here, 999. If any value is present, it will take the count. I'll come here, we got the range. Now get values. It is very important when you are fetching data from particular cells, right? Multiple cells, then values should be there. And if you are fetching data only for one cell, it should be only get value. This is a very big mistake which usually beginners does, right? That they put only value everywhere. So we should understand what we are pulling the data, right? So with the help of this line, what will happen? I will get complete list of email addresses in this array or variable. Now let me create one more variable, length. Okay, and I will just write email array dot length. Now this length variable will contain the number of email addresses stored in this container, this variable, and this length can be referenced here. Okay, now let's see whether it is working or not. I'll just go to my account. I'll just read all the mails. Cool. Now I'll go come back. I'll just run it. Let's wait whether it is happening or not. Perfect. It is happening. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cool. Now let's see if my email addresses are increased, and let's say it is also increasing and there is somebody, and after that I'll run it again. I'll just read the all inbox, go to the code, run it, and I should receive more than 7 emails. If I receive more than 7 emails, that means my code is working fine and it is perfect. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, perfect, 9, 10. So that means we have successfully modified our code, in which we have informed our script, go to this sheet, take all the email IDs, take all these respective subjects and email bodies and send the mail. This is a very simple script, but it is very useful when there is a lengthy, tedious work of emailing everyone, right? A lot of, or you can say a bulk email send you have to do. So this is a very useful script. And do let me know if you have any doubts in this. Let me know in the comments. I'll improvise the code, or you can say I can improvise my way of explaining. And if you like this video, I would request you to please like or comment or do something on the comment section so that I can know that my stuff is really useful for you. Thank you very much.